Hi, welcome to our website. My name is Jim Beckler. I'd like to show you a brand new 2017 Sunseeker 24W motorhome today. This is a really nice floor plan. It's got a full wall slide, so if you're looking for a smaller coach that you can get in and out of a lot of spots, this would be a great choice. It's built on a Mercedes Sprinter chassis, so it has a great chassis that's good overall handling and driving, good mileage. It's very economical. This is one of our more popular floor plans, and people seem to really enjoy the Sprinter chassis. As we probably, you've already know, it's one of those things Mercedes has built into their coaches is engineering and quality and safety. So those are two big things with that company. Start off by mentioning that it does have full body paint. This is actually a new paint scheme, so it's a little different color than they've had in the past. Really nice earth tones. Gives you full body paint's going to last much longer as far as the looks of the vehicle. Over a period of time, things aren't going to break down like when you have decals. It's just a matter of time, usually, if they're out in the sun, where they start to fade and peel. Full body paint will not do that, so it adds to the resale value of the coach down the road. Plus, it looks much nicer for a longer period of time. Do you have a nice little step getting up inside of here? Notice the awning has a full, just about a full awning almost down the whole side of this coach. Good size awning. This is electric too, by the way, so just a push of a button and it's going in and out. No muss, no fuss. This one's equipped with Helwig sway control too, so they do have sway control devices on this coach to help eliminate some of the rocking motions from when you're going down the road or maybe going around corners. I like the fact that it does have, it's already wired for solar, so if you're a dry camper, you might want to get yourself a little portable solar panel that you can plug in right here and move around, get some sun on that thing, and keep your batteries charged up while you're out there. Access to the propane tanks right here, easy to get to. Have, excuse me, storage compartments all the way around. Notice this is a rotocast material, so it's real easy to keep clean. Again, really nice paint. If you come around to the back, notice that it does have frameless windows, adds to the look of the vehicle, and it's already set up with the tow package. So this is right, it has a 5,000 pound hitch on it, so you have no problem pulling a small car or some kind of a vehicle behind you, or even a boat. On this side, this is the side that has the slide. You can see it's pretty much a full wall slide. Awning over the top to protect it from debris and too much water. Then you have access to outside shower, storage, all those things. Your hookups over here for for your sewer. Looks like it's got a little sewer hose already with it. Shower, your sewer cord. And this one is equipped with a generator, so you're fully self-contained here. It has a 3600 watt LP generator, so you got propane generator, nice and quiet and efficient. Again, more storage. That'll utilize the space by giving you storage in different areas. So we come around back to the front. Might point out too, this one does have side view cameras, so it has a backup monitor on the back and also side view cameras, which adds to the safety of the vehicle. So when you're going down the road, if you were going to change lanes, you could say you hit that turn signal to go into the right lane. That display will show what's going on down that side of the coach, so it helps eliminate some of the blind spots. Nice safety feature, really like that. You notice you got nice mirrors on the side too. Before we go in, I will point out that I think it's important to note that it does have a one-piece fiberglass roof, so it's not a TPO or a rubber roof. So the fiberglass roofs are more durable. They're less likely to break down from the weather if it's out in the weather much. So it's a nice feature too. Notice this one has a pretty aerodynamic front. So it's a more of a lower profile. As we go in, you'll see why. Let's take a look up here in the front in the cockpit area. I mentioned that drivability is huge on these coaches. They really drive nice. It's more like driving a van or a passenger car than it is a motorhome in a lot of ways. Great fuel economy. We talked to a lot of people that are very satisfied with the type of mileage they get. Of course, that's going to vary, but we hear a lot of reports in that 15 to 17 miles per gallon range. So that's for a motorhome, that's great. It does have automatic transmission. This one has a slapstick feature, which will allow you to shift up and down manually if you prefer to shift gears while you're going down the road. Let's say, for example, you're going up a hill and you want to drop down into a lower gear quicker than the vehicle wants to shift for you. You can have a little more control over that. It will do it all by itself, so it's not that you have to do that. It's just one of those features that gives you a little bit more control over the vehicle. The other nice feature on this, I think, that's really worth mentioning is that it does have, like a lot of your passenger cars now, it started with your luxury cars, almost everything now has yaw sensors in the automotive industry, not so much in the RV industry, but this one will be able to determine driver intent. So in other words, if you're going around a corner a little bit too fast, it's going to note that, and it'll make corrections to the wheels using either the brakes to the wheels or power to the wheels to help bring you back into the correct path that you were intending to go. It's a good thing to have help eliminate some of the potential problems out there. So really, by the time you figured out you might be a little bit in not going where you want to go, it's already making corrections for you. Notice on the front, I mentioned this is a little more aerodynamic. This has the lower profile front end, so you have instead of a bed up here, it's got more storage. Your entertainment center's up here, of course, your TV mounted up here. This also has a release, so you can swing this out too. There's a little bit more storage back in here also, but let's have a nice little flat screen TV. And this is all designed, this is all set up now too, so that you can play movies in here. So if you wanted to sit and watch a movie, you could just slide your DVD in there, or if you want to listen to music, it'll play your CDs also. Both front seats are going to spin around, makes it nice. Got a little table that pulls in and out. I just have the table in there now, but it just pulls right out, so obviously you don't have to have it in there when you're traveling, but just gives you a little bit more versatility as far as the furniture goes to be able to spin those seats back around. Notice the nice big wraparound dinette. This will also make into a bed. It's a pretty deep slide out, so you actually have quite a bit of room back in here. Now I like the fact you do have large drawers that go underneath, so you've got good storage with a great place to be able to put some of your gear that you want to take with you, maybe even pots and pans. Metal glides, so you can put some weight in here and they're going to hold up. You might be wondering what this box is back here. That's barbecue. It has comes with an outside barbecue already set up to be able to plug right into the side of your coach. So you can get out there and get that barbecue going. I like the fact it has a little bit of a sunlight or a skylight here too that does let in some sunlight. You can block this out if you want to. It has both a day and night shade, but like on a day like this where it's kind of cloudy and rainy, it's nice to be able to open that up and let in a little bit more natural light. It does have good windows too, but it really helps to let some of that light come in from up above. You do have light control. Speaking of lighting, you have lights here and power ports right here, 110 outlet. Even has cup holders in the back. This one has adjustable shelves here and a pantry, so you got a nice little pantry area. You could pull these out if you wanted to. Actually, Use this to hang clothes into if you needed to, but it's kind of designed for either or. And these are, like I said, all really adjustable. In here, we've got closet space. This is all for your barbecue to set up. Got the stand for that, so you can set that up out there. The little bolsters back here are to sit on your front seats. When you spin those around, you can sit those on your seat so that you sit up a little bit higher, so your feet aren't right there next to the ground. Again, more drawers. Utilize the space well. You've got good storage. Notice it does have a walk-around bed, queen size, the TV up here. The air conditioning in this is all ducted as well, so you get air and heat inside the bathroom area. Nice stand-up shower, skylight above again to let in some natural light, toilet, sink. It's a little medicine cabinet, place storage there, storage down below here also. Kitchen area is laid out nice. Again, a little bit smaller coach. You're going to have compact items. There's the plug-in for your barbecue. Has the water filter here for your fresh water coming in. The refrigerator is gas and electric, so it'll operate off of either or. Notice you do have separate freezer. I like the fact you've got controls right here, kind of a central command. They call it a convenience center. You've got your generator start right here. Check your tank levels, see how you're doing for your fresh water, maybe your black tank. Hot water heater, gas or electric, so it'll operate off of either element. Turn your water pump on from here, slide controls. I love this feature. It's an Arctic pack, so this is actually designed to go out in inclement weather. If you're out in some cold weather and you're concerned about the tanks getting heat to them, you can actually turn that on. You're going to get heat on your holding tanks to keep things from freezing up. And then you have lighting there as well. Comes with the convection microwave and a nice three burner stovetop. I like what they've designed here too, with a nice flat surface, so you can use this for workspace if you like to. And then you do have, again, more storage under here. It's a great place there for pots and pans too, actually. And again, nice metal glides, storage. Can never have too much storage, right? Nice deep stainless steel sink. And some more drawers up above here. If you want to swing around here for just a second, I probably should have pointed this out when we came in, but it does have controls right here too, next to the steps coming into your coach. You have your disconnect, battery disconnect right now, so it was off. I just switched it on, so now I can, all my lights come on. So when I'm storing this, I can just hit it in the off, turn it to the off position, and I'm not going to draw power from my batteries. You have your controls right here for the rear stabilizers, awning controls right here, and then you have lighting controls right there as well. Does have, you know, this is a nice feature too, so when you get to where you're camping, you can just hit that button and bring those stabilizers down, kind of help eliminate some of the rocking motions when you're out in the unit itself. So again, maybe you're looking for a really nice smaller motorhome. This could be a great choice. It's a Sunseeker 24W by Forest River. This is part of Berkshire Hathaway's umbrella of companies. We like the product, we like the company, and you know, we feel like we're a good place to do business. Again, my name is Jim Beckler, so if you would ask for me, I'd sure appreciate it. You can reach me at 541-510-1017. Just give me a call and I'll be glad to help.